systems. What you all know, that is we have the axis cap filtration, we have the biomechanical filtration, then we have the obturation, and then we proceed with the core filter, that is a post filter. Now, today we will be discussing about the axis cap filtration. What does it involve in this system? That is, until and unless we get a direct entry or direct access to the canals, the infection is not going to get through. That is, we can treat only what you can see. So, for proper medication of medium, for proper placement of medication, and proper 3D observation, access cavity of these are prior importance. Now, what are the objectives of access cavity? These are actually the traditional objectives. That is, we have to remove all cavities. That is very important. That is, we have to remove all cavities. Otherwise, a portal of entry for the bacteria will be removed. So, we have to remove all the remaining cavities. Then, we have to conserve the sound tooth structure. That is, tooth structure, remaining tooth structure, we have to preserve as much as tooth structure as possible. Now, we have to completely unroot the pulp chamber. We have to remove all coronal pulp tissue. And the traditional principle, one of the principles is straight line access. Now, in cultivating or newer access designs, that has been changed. And to lock in all the root canal orifices. That is, every tooth anatomy is different. So, we have to search for as much as hidden orifices as possible. We have to keep all the water hidden for the bacteria. And we have to establish respective margins to minimize marginal leakage. That is, strong margins should be established that eliminate any leakage. Now, we have certain blows to locate the canal orifices. So, today we will be discussing that blows and what are the access designs. Under access cavity, we have a lot of headings. These two headings will be covered today. That is, what are all blows? There are blows, certain blows to locate the canal orifices. So, what are that blows and what are the newer access designs available or the classification of access designs? So, blow was proposed by Krasner and Randall. They proposed certain blows to locate the canal orifices. First is the low central loop. That is, the floor of pulp chamber is always located at the center of the loop at the level of CG. So when you consider the level of CG, the floor, the pulp chamber floor will be always located at the center. That is the low central loop. Now next we have another low, that is the low of pulp chamber. From the very beginning, there will be a pulp chamber. So it will be more dark. That is, the pulp chamber floor is always darker in color than the bottom. The figure we can appreciate that the floor will be darker compared to the walls. Thus, we can locate the floor. Next, we have the law of concentration. What is that? That the walls are always concentric to the external surface of the tooth. That is, when we can see the figure, comparing the external surface of the tooth. Okay, the walls will be always same. That is, from here, that the distance will be same. Now we have next row, that is the low of CEG. That is, the distance from the external surface of the crown to the wall is the same throughout the circumference. That is, this distance from this external surface to this area, from here, every word will be same. So, considering that, we can find out where the exact floor of the pulp chamber or the orifices are. That is the low of concentration. Now we have something known as a law of symmetry. Under we have first law and second law. What is the first law of symmetry? It states that it's not applicable for the maxillary nerves. For all other two, the canal orifices are equidistant from the line drawn in an isodistant direction through the center of the pulp chamber floor. That is, when we consider a line, that is, this is a mesial and this is the distal surface, when we consider the line mesiodistant, the orifices will be equidistant from this line. So this is the line from here, the orifices will be except for maximum. That is the first law of symmetry. Now, what is the second law of symmetry? Here the canal orifices lie on a line perpendicular to a line drawn in the east-western direction. That is, here we have a line in the east-western direction. Now, consider here also there is a line. So, first we said that it is equidistant from that line. While second row, that is, when we draw a perpendicular line to this mesodistal line, then this orifices will lie on that line. So, for that is the first row, and we have another second row. Hope it is clear. That is, orifices will be equidistant from a mesodistal line, first row. While when we draw perpendicular to this mesodistal line, orifices lie on that line. That is the second law of symmetry. Now, next row is, that is, the law of orifice location. Again, we have three. That is, the orifices are at the junction. nose, that is the orifices are formed at the junction of the bone and floor. And at that junction is very wide. And at that junction, bird would be, that is implied by the second bone. The angles in the floor bone. We have a floor, we have a bone. At that point, angle, we have the orifice. And to be more specific, third bone, the terminus of the two developmental fusion lines. So these were the various roles. We have a lot of centrality, parenchyme, parts of the city, symmetry, and the orifice proportion. Even by plastic and plantar. That work comprises the nose. Now moving to various exoskeleton classification of various designs. First one is the conventional axis of it. That does we obtain the straight line axis, and we have certain morphologies for each two, how it will be long or triangular. And we have to understand or we have to learn each axis. So to conclude with we made update regarding this newer access design imaging modalities, where we have to make sure it's done with proper armamentarium and proper imaging modalities.